I am Shah, ISO 9000 quality consultant with over 40 years of experience. In the last video, I have covered ISO 9000 audit of a construction project, including inspection of drawings, reports, documents, interviewing and talking to people. Mr. Sawant, the builder, was cooperative. He provided all the details required for the ISO 9000 audit. We now begin the second part covering inspection and visit to site, interviewing people on the construction project. Visit to site. I am at project site at 8 a.m. Mr. Sawant is ready with his team of engineers. Site inspection begins. Number one. Show me your concrete testing laboratory. Mr. Sawant quickly led me to a compact office with laboratory equipments. Concrete cube compression testing machine was available. What about calibration certificate? The QC man quickly pointed to a certificate pasted on the whiteboard. I said, "This is good." Sand and metal sieves were used for sieve analysis of materials. Moisture measuring equipment available. What about your indoor storage areas? Storage room was full of tiles, plumbing and electrical wires, fixtures, switches, door handles, hinges, doors, window frames, paint boxes, marbles, all the materials were mixed up. When I asked the storage keeper why the materials were not properly kept in place, he replied that the storage room is small. Besides, nobody has time to put the materials in order. When I asked him about the total cost of inventory, he was not able to give me the cost. Mr. Sawant replied that do not keep inventory of materials on site. Number 3. Outdoor storage. Metal 1 and 2 were kept side by side, but no separating wall was built. The materials were getting mixed up. Steel bars 8 mm, 12 mm, 16 mm, 20 mm were dumped on the ground and were mixed up. Some steel bars were also placed directly on water tank slab. Number 4. RCC structures. Let us inspect the quality of your RCC work. Concreting. All the elements were with M20 concrete with OPC 53 grade of cement. Mixed design was available. Bulging was found at a number of places in beams and columns. Honeycomb was observed in a number of beams and columns. Slab levels were found to be undulating. The difference was up to 75 mm. Concrete covers in a number of columns varied between 0 mm to 100 mm. Ready mix concrete. Concrete compressive strength is satisfactory. Show me the records of water cement ratio, amount of fly ash use, amount of crushed sand use, amount of plasticizer retarder use. The records were not available. Five. External walls. Let us inspect your external walls. 6-inch brickwork is used. Statutory requirement is 9-inch brickwork. No reports are available for testing of brick compressive strength, brick water absorption. The masonry joints vary between 12 mm to 40 mm. Joints between RCC members and masonry left undone. Type of cement is PPC 43 grade. Mortar is hand mix. Number 6. Concrete blocks and masonry. Let us see your concrete blocks and masonry. The concrete blocks were stacked more than 12 high. Concrete blocks were cured for 10 days and used in masonry without drying. Masonry joints varied between 25 mm to 75 mm. Number 7. External plaster. Mr. Sawant, how do you carry out external plaster? Mr. Sawant was proud to tell that they are using machine mixed mortar. They are also using waterproofing compound added in the mortar. What about the water jet test for waterproofing leakages? Mr. Sawant regretted that they do not carry out such test. Eight, internal plaster, hand mix mortar. No control on time of mixing and use of mortar within a stipulated time. Nine, toilet waterproofing. Show me your procedure for toilet waterproofing. Hand mix mortar with waterproofing agent. Toilet slab 4 inch thick. Bonding test for 7 days. Mr. Sawant, what about the records of bonding test? Mr. Sawant regretted that no records have been kept. Mr. Sawant, what waterproofing agent you are using? Mr. Sawant or his engineers did not know about the agent. Number 10. Work environment and safety. Workers' quarters. No urinals, toilets, drinking water. Workers' colony is overcrowded, dirty and stinks. Supervising engineers have no independent tables, chairs. Mr. Sawant, your work environment is stinking. Mr. Sawant had tears in his eyes, confessed that he did not pay attention to this aspect. Eleven, visit to a sample flat. Door frames are of marble, aluminum windows with smooth movement. Internal plaster is smooth, level, and paint is attractive. Bathroom fittings, fixtures are of good quality. Electrical switches, good quality. Tiles are marble and laid neatly. Approach to the sample flat is clear, decorated with flower pots on either side. Number 12. What about internal audit report? Mr. Sawant replied that they do not have the practice of internal audit, as nobody is trained for internal auditing. Thirteen, checklist. Can you show me some checklist for waterproofing of toilet blocks, terrace, masonry, plaster, concreting, etc. One of Mr. Sawant's engineers ran and found some checklist. Mr. Sawant said, "The checklists are there. Nobody has time to fill up the checklist."14. Safety. What about safety plan, safety manual, safety toolbox, talk, accident reporting, regular doctor visit? Mr. Sawant replied that for safety, all our engineers and workers wear safety helmets and safety belts are provided to the workers. Signboard showing caution, work in progress is available. We have not thought more on safety plan, etc. Safety helmets, first aid, shoes, belts are provided. This completes part 2 of ISO 9000 audit of a construction project, inspection and visit to site, interviewing people. Wait for our next video, part 3, end of audit with observations and conclusion. Thank you for watching. Subscribe now. Visit our website www.constructionlearning.com for more information on quality management of construction projects, downloading of free articles, professional training programs, proof checking details, and free one-day training offered to engineering and architecture students in and around Mumbai on ISO 9000 quality management. For any clarifications required, you can email us at ishabby@constructionlearning.com.